The year was 1966. I had started production of a television series entitled Captain Scarlet and the Mysterons. It was an action-adventure show made with puppets and state-of-the-art special effects. The result was a programme that was unique and enjoyed worldwide distribution. Since that time, Captain Scarlet and the Mysterons has been repeated on television over and over again around the world and has been seen by countless millions of children and their parents. The children who originally watched Captain Scarlet are now adults, many of whom have children of their own. Then along came the DVD. Adults who watched the shows as children started to buy Captain Scarlet and the Mysteron DVDs to take a trip down memory lane, and of course their children watched with them. Today, Captain Scarlet and the Mysterons is known and loved by family audiences throughout the world, and so Captain Scarlet is now an established title with a format that fits into the world as it is today. It was a perfect show for a remake. Over the years, the art of creating computer-generated images, CGI, improved and became a new art form which I quickly realised was the perfect medium for me to use to make the new Captain Scarlet series. And so I set to work. Now came the difficult part. I briefed the directors and the crew. I told them we were going to make the finest family show of its kind ever made for television. The show was to be action-packed, the famous puppet characters were to be transformed into actors, and the stories were to combine stunning scenery, futuristic sets, and mind-blowing action.
Destiny Angel to control. We're returning to base.
It was essential that the characters could be able to walk, run, jump, fight, and in fact do all the movements that people can do. Each character was to have its own body language, and so we used a system called motion capture. Fortunately, the type of shows that I make automatically lend themselves to consumer products. Skybase is an aerial platform from which the Angel aircraft can be launched, and a variety of other aircraft such as helicopters and private jets can land. The Falcon interceptors, flown by the Angels. The Bison is an alien terrain vehicle which was used for the original reconnaissance of Mars, which led to the discovery of the Mysterons. The Cheetah is a rapid response vehicle capable of high speed with remarkable road-holding ability. It can transform into flight mode when necessary, which gives it the ability to jump across obstacles in its path. The Rhino is a tactical response unit. As its name suggests, it is large, heavy, and can be very dangerous if you get in its way. The Albatross is a Spectrum special deployment vehicle based on Skybase. The Condor is a giant transport aircraft. In our series, Condors are in use throughout the world in the same way as today's Boeing 747. The American president has a 747 that has been specially adapted. It is called Air Force One. In the same way, Spectrum have a number of Condors which have been modified for their use, and they carry the Spectrum logo. The Swift is a small passenger jet and is a futuristic version of today's Learjet. The Vampire is the pride of the American Army Air Force, a multi-purpose fighter bomber which has proved itself in aerial battles and is acknowledged to be the finest aircraft in the world. There is only one exception, the Angel Interceptor. The Hummingbird is a futuristic helicopter developed for Spectrum's exclusive use. The Drusnik is a gargantuan Russian machine. It is the biggest battle tank ever built. The Skyrider is a one-person flying motorbike. It can be seen flying along the canyons in New York and is a vehicle widely used by Spectrum personnel. The Stallion Raid Bike is a three-wheeled motorbike which can be launched from Sky Base Runway. You enjoy the three episodes on this DVD. The new Captain Scarlet is my production. And as the Coca-Cola ads say, it's the real thing.